It's always an exciting time of year, and I think I say this every year when we get to this point. Some of you parents who've had older children have probably heard me say this. I can't believe it. I can't believe a whole year has passed again, and we have another group of students ready to move on to the middle school. It's been a great year filled with a lot of activities for our children. Early on in the school year this year, having well, I still think of it as winter camp, but certainly was fall camp this year. Obviously, your children being involved in DARE all of the school year and working as safeties for us at school. It's been a tremendous year packed with lots and lots of different activities for the kids, and we're so glad that you're able to participate in all of those things. We do have a packed program for you this afternoon. And funny, the air conditioning just doesn't seem to be working today. We don't have any. So I know it's going to be plenty warm, but we'll have a good time in spite of the heat. We're going to start out our program with a couple of songs from our fifth graders. The first one is called Graduation, and the second song is a song our kids have composed the words to. It's called Dare, and you will certainly recognize the tune when you hear it, but they've composed words that are meaningful to them and to the Dare program. So I'll turn it over to Mr. Brower.
Need for a night. I don't want you to wreck your life.
athletes to leave for another program in one of our other buildings, so that's why we wanted to begin with our songs. Now we'll go to the original beginning, which was our Pledge of Allegiance, and we have two of our students who are student council representatives are going to lead us in that, Jacob Oberg and Katie Lawson. Would you please stand? Officer Myers, who is our DARE officer this year. Officer Myers has worked with the students all semester, has been here at school many, many hours working with our children. We really appreciate the time that she's been able to give to our program. And at this time, Officer Myers will come up.
Myers mentioned some of the lessons that you go over when you're in there. I think those are really important. They help you with the things you're going to face as you go into middle school, high school, and into life. But a couple of them, I think, are really important to you. I mean, your parents, I think, will be able to tell you about some of those too, because you're not going to just use them for drugs, but there's a lot of things in your life. When you talk about peer pressure, that's something that we face all the time. I bet you if you ask your parents, when they go to work, they find peer pressure there sometimes. Important part of that, then, is you learn how to say no. What is it, 8 ways to say no, something like that? But then what's also important is not only how to say no, but when to say no, right? There's times you just got to say no to people because they're leading you the wrong way. And then finally, what really fits in with that well is consequences. Because when we say no at the right time and make the right choices, the consequences are pretty good, aren't they? And then those days when we don't do quite as well, the consequences aren't as favorable. So those are important things that we experience every day. I see it's my job that I have to look at those kind of things, of peer pressure, and when to say no, and how to say no, when to say yes, and how to say yes also. And the consequences, because that's an important part of what our day-to-day lives are. When you talk to your parents, I bet you they'll tell you about that. That every day in their life, they face those same things. So those lessons that you learn now will go with you for a long time. I think the time that you spent on this and the effort you put into it was very good. I've got to tell you, that song that you did, you put a lot of work into that too, and I really enjoyed that. And it speaks well of how much work you're willing to put into something, and just the time to learn it and perform it. It's greatly appreciated by all of us. Now, what I didn't tell you about when I started this, I always have a test for these things. Are you ready for a test?
Yeah.
Did you expect that today? Okay, sort of. Okay. Well, I think you do well on this one. I always used to ask the students this, and there's two very important groups of people here. And until the other night I was doing one, somebody reminded me there was three important groups. I'm going to see if you can help me identify them. Who's the important people here today? Who's the most important group here today?
The kids?
Yeah, absolutely. The kids. That's first and foremost. Now, we have two more to go. Who's another important group of people here today? Your parents, yeah. And why are they important to us? Yeah, exactly. Very good. Now, what's the other important group of people?
The teachers.
Yeah, the teachers. Because they help you through these lessons, they give you time to learn, and they help you along the way, right? So that's three very important groups of people. I just want to take a minute and say thank you to the parents for, number one, being here today and showing your support for your kids. And we appreciate that, and I think that's a very important part of their success. But then for the support that you show them every day of their life and the time you spend with them, because that really is critical to their future. Well, good news, guys. You did very good on the test. Thank you. You passed it. I guess we can go on with your graduation. Is that all right?
Yes.
Mentioned the DARE essay. Each student had to complete a DARE essay, had to read it in front of the class, and then the class voted on two representatives from each class that they wanted to be here today to share their essays with you. At this time, I'd like to call up all of the DARE essay representatives. They're going to introduce themselves. Come on up. They're going to introduce themselves. Let you know what class they're in, and then read their essay with you.
I also think DARE would be helpful to
lung disease and cancer to the mouth. Cigarette smoking can lead to heart trouble, lung disease, and cancer. Cocaine can cause heart troubles, damage to the nose, violent behaviors, and maybe even death. Kids may ask you to take those drugs, maybe even adults. It's sometimes hard to say no because you don't want to look stupid or lose a friend, and they may be pressuring you to take it. A good way to say no is say no, thank you, and give a reason why. If someone is pressuring you, just say no and ignore the name calling and other things. That person might get you to take the drug or do something against the law. Sometimes you should tell why you're not going to take the drug and tell how it can hurt the body. DARE stands for Drug Abuse Resistance Education. I'm glad that Officer Myers came to teach it to the fifth grade. I learned a lot in DARE, and I am not going to take drugs or do anything against the law. I am going to say no.
We also learned that all drugs do is ruin your life and are one bit cool. In the DARE booklet, there were stories about kids our age getting in situations about drugs and other things. We answered the questions about what we would do. In one story about self-esteem with two girls our age, their names were Marsha and Stacy. Marsha chooses not to do her homework, be a bad sport, and doesn't like to help around the house. Stacy chooses to do her homework, be a good sport, and help around the house. You can tell that Marsha has low self-esteem and Stacy has high self-esteem. I think it is very important to stay drug-free. I think this because you could lose friends, get in trouble, or be violent. But if you choose not to do drugs, it will be exactly opposite. I learned a lot in DARE. I think this program should keep going on throughout the years. Now I will choose friends and fun over drugs and violence any day.
Why it's good to stay drug-free and violence-free, and the eight different ways to say no. The reasons why I like DARE are because you learn a lot from your DARE officer and your DARE book. Every week you write down some definitions, some weeks one and some weeks two. Then there are the fact sheets. They tell you what the different drugs do to your body. One of the facts I read was the amount of people dying each day from cigarettes is the same as two jumbo jets crashing each day and everyone on them dying. There are also some tests that only you will get 100% on, because it's about your own feelings. Then there are some stories on taking risks and the consequences you get for taking them. There are also some coupons to show a teacher, classmate, and family member you care for them very much. Did you know that there are eight different ways to say no? All eight of these can help you in a predicament. The two that I use the most are number one and two. Number one is saying no thanks, while number two says give a reason or excuse. Whenever I'm in a predicament, I use one of these eight, or one that's very similar. I personally am scared of going to middle school, high school, and college. Middle school because I'm afraid I get asked to do drugs or drink alcoholic beverages. DARE's helped take some of that fear away. I'm scared of high school because of the bomb threats, and college because of the riots. The rioting MSU students drank too much alcohol, which made them think that the riot would be fun, but didn't think of the consequences until after they had done it. Those are my reasons on why I like DARE, what I learned from it, and why it's important to stay drug-free and violence-free. I think DARE is a good program, and I hope it continues at Raleigh and across the United States.
DARE is a great program that should be taught to all fifth graders.
Deer teaches us many things relating to drugs, violence, consequences to actions, and much more. I have learned a lot in the DEER program. In DEER, we have learned about the different drugs and how they affect you. To me, it is very important to stay drug-free. This is very important because drugs can affect your body, life, health, and life in many terrible ways. Drugs make you have stained teeth, bad breath, affect your memory, can make you think of feeling. They can slow down your heart rate and give you many diseases such as heart diseases, cancer, AIDS, hepatitis, and many more. Drugs can also affect relationships. If you're not thinking clearly, you can't care about the people you love. If children are taking drugs, they are often disobedient to their parents and teachers. Another thing the students in our classroom have learned is how to stay drug-free. Some of the things that we can do is not go to parties where drugs are included. You can hang out with drug-free friends and participate in many positive school activities, such as bands, sports, clubs, etc. These are all ways that help you stay away from drugs. Violence is not the way to solve problems. Friends can get you in trouble and can hurt you very badly. If you are injured by physical abuse, guns, knives, etc., it can drastically affect your life in the future. Also, if you are the abuser, you can go to jail. Whether you are the abuser or victim, violence can change your life negatively. To avoid violence, you should choose to stay away from video games, movies, computer games, music, etc., that includes violence. You can also stay away from violence by choosing friends who can handle differences without violence. By avoiding drugs and violence, you will live a better and happier life without suffering the consequences. The students in our classroom have learned many things in the DEER program. DEER has also encouraged communication about these issues between my parents and me. I am thankful that the DEER program encourages good choices concerning these issues.
Program for my grade. It has taught us how to be drug and violence free. Being drug and violence free helps you become a better person and helps us grow in many ways. These are some reasons drug is beneficial to children. DEER is a crucial part of our education at Raleigh Elementary. It prepares us for middle school and high school, where drugs are more common than at Raleigh. DEER also helps us say no in many ways, like the cold shoulder, walking away, saying no thanks, and others too. This is what makes DEER a wonderful program. The DEER program helps kids realize good and bad effects of drugs and violence. When you take too many good drugs or even just a few bad drugs, you can suffer from horrible side effects like lung cancer, emphysema, bad breath, loss of memory and strength. Violence can get you in trouble or harm you physically. You can get in a fight and kill someone or get thrown in jail for life. DEER is a way of keeping kids out of such trouble. Being drug-free is also very important. It can get you a good job. If you're violent or on drugs, only drugs could probably get what you need with it. Not many people would even want to be your friend. These are some reasons violence and drugs can really mess up your adult life. In conclusion, DEER is an important part of our education. It teaches us how and why to avoid drugs and violence, and as I see it, being drug and violence free is especially good. The DEER program should continue for years to come at Raleigh.
Drugs, violence, gangs, media pressure, and more. It's important to make sure kids know about these not-so-great experiences with drugs. We need to make good decisions. In order to do that, we need DEER to help us. In DEER, I have learned how to say no to drugs. Officer Myers taught us these 8 ways to say no. 1, just saying no thanks. 2, giving a reason or excuse. 3, the broken record saying no. 4, just walking away. 5, changing the subject. 6, avoid the situation. 7, give the cold shoulder. And 8, strength in numbers. These 8 ways of saying no may be very useful to you someday, but you may not think so, but you never know. I think it's important to stay drug and violence free because they can get you into a lot of trouble. For instance, if you try a drug or alcohol for the first time and think, oh, nothing bad will happen just trying them once, the bad symptoms come over you after trying drugs just once. These symptoms may include dizziness, blackouts, passing out, large tempers, vomiting, and other awful effects. I feel that the DEER program is a fun way to learn about serious things. Sometimes in DEER class, we got to act out some of the situations in the book. DEER is an outstanding way to learn about drugs. Kids need to make good decisions, and to make them, we need DEER. DEER is an extremely worthwhile program every week, once a week, for fifth graders. I truly appreciate all the things about drugs, violence, gangs, the media, pressure, and more that DEER has taught. pushes us to do something we will not know how to respond. When we need DARE, it will be there for us.
Hi, I am Sandy Sessions, and I feel that more kids our age are hurting each other in society, and the DARE program is one of the many programs that teaches us to follow our dreams without the use of drugs and alcohol. I learned that you don't have to do drugs to be cool. Being cool is being yourself. Most kids don't worry about drugs. We worry about making the soccer team, going to the middle school, growing up, and how we did our math test. We know that doing drugs can ruin our future and dreams for the future, but a few kids ignore that. They've probably seen their older friends or siblings doing drugs and how relaxed, happy, and funny they seem. But after the drugs wear off, they need more drugs to keep them feeling happy. Their bodies and brains are slowly being destroyed. More kids are doing commercials against drugs, and sometimes when grown-ups see them, they think that we are just doing them for fun, but we are not. We are doing them because we are ashamed of the choices that some of our peers and some grown-ups are making. Doing drugs, getting young people to do drugs, and hanging out with people who do drugs. Most questions come with more than one answer, but this question only has one good answer. Can drugs be more important than your future or goals for life? You have to decide because for us, fifth and sixth graders tomorrow is our future. Kids that go around offering drugs would remember the stuff that they learned in fifth grade. None of this would be happening. I feel great about the DARE program and think that people all over the world should listen to what DARE officers and drug-free people have to say. I have learned lots of things that are important. One of them is staying off drugs. Drugs can do many harmful things to your body. They can make you dizzy and make you lose your memory. Once you take drugs, your body wants more, then more. This is called getting addicted. Then people that get addicted to drugs will go and offer other people drugs. Sometimes they pressure the person they are offering. There are four types of peer pressure. They are heavy, indirect, friendly, and teasing. Heavy pressure would be where a person kept on asking you. Friendly would be where a person offered, and if you said no, they would not ask you again. Teasing is where someone might call you names. The reason why I think it is important to stay off drugs is so you could accomplish your goals. Drugs hurt your body, so why take them? Anyway, if you are in a gang being violent after drugs, you probably will be caught. I know that drugs are bad for my body. They can make me hurt someone else. I think that everyone should stay off drugs. I'm Natalie Pinedo from Mr. Blair's. The Drug Abuse Resistance Education, or DARE program, is very effective and worthwhile. Participants learn about drugs, violence, peer pressure, youth gangs, media, how to say no, and more. I think that DARE has a positive effect on young people because of this. I participated in DARE and learned many things. One topic we discussed was good drugs and bad drugs. Good drugs are a medication of some sort, sometimes prescribed by a doctor, to help heal something or get rid of a sickness. But good drugs can have harmful effects on people if used or not used properly. One example is when someone takes an overdose of medication. Another example is when someone takes medication when they do not need it. A bad drug is like cocaine, tobacco, marijuana, and alcohol. Bad drugs hurt you. They are not meant to help you. Some people take these drugs to get high or feel good. Some people can get addicted to drugs and can't stop taking them. This is very bad for you. Some people take drugs to be cool, fit, and a little older. Sometimes a person's friends or peers put pressure on them to do drugs. Peer pressure. Also, people sometimes are influenced to do drugs by the media. Famous people who do drugs are advertisements they see or hear. The media advertising drugs says it's cool to do drugs, or a lot of good things will happen to you if you do drugs. Sometimes kids don't have any friends, so they join a group of young people who are violent and do drugs called the youth gang. There is a lot of peer pressure to do bad things when a person is in a youth gang. The kid is involved in activities, then they will probably make friends without having to turn to drugs and violence. It is my opinion that it is important to stay drug-free and violence-free. That way you can enjoy the good things in life. That is why DARE teaches kids about drugs and violence, so kids will know how to make the right decision. I think that DARE is a very good educational experience.
questions about drugs. Kids start the DARE program and have many questions. They graduate the DARE program with all their questions answered and knowing many things about drugs. The DARE program is a positive alternative. I feel that DARE is a very fun and educational subject for kids to learn in school. Every kid and adult needs to learn the consequences of drugs and how to say no to them. The kids will be asked to try or be offered them by friends. Unless the kids know how to say no, they won't say no. DARE has taught my friends and I many things. It has taught us the 8 ways to say no. The 8 ways are saying no thanks, giving a reason or excuse, repeated refusal, or keep saying no, walking away, changing the subject, avoiding the situation, cold shoulder, and strength in numbers. I have learned the effect and consequences of drugs, and how the word drugs doesn't mean marijuana or cocaine all the time. Although those are drugs, it can also mean aspirin or Tylenol. So the effect of drugs can be good or bad, depending on what kind of drug you take and the amount of it. The DARE program gives you a better life. You may not understand how, but it does. It does by keeping you drug-free. It is important to stay drug-free because you will have a better life if you do. DARE is a program that helps kids have a better life. The DARE program helps me stay drug-free. I think that everyone should go through the DARE program. I really enjoyed it. I think that anyone else who has done it has liked it too. The DARE program is a positive alternative.
At this time, we'll be having the presentation of our certificates. And I want to give directions to the classrooms so you will know how this will work. When your class is called, we'll have your entire class stand along the west wall of the gym. And I know you're seated alphabetically already, the A's and B's. The A's should be near the open door. And then we will have your teacher up front who will be giving you your fifth grade certificate, and I'll show you everybody what that looks like. Each of the students receives a fifth grade sort of diploma that they'll be receiving from their fifth grade teacher. And then you will also receive your DARE certificate from Officer Myers, and you'll be able to shake their hands. They'll be up front here next to the U.S. flag. Then when you receive your certificates, if you would go to this side of the room and line up in front so everybody will be able to see you all together, your entire class, not the whole grade, but just your class. And then we will hold the applause until we have all of each class lined up over here, and then we'll give them a nice round of applause when we get everybody over on that side. So we're going to be starting today with Mr. Zyra's class. So if Mr. Zyra's class would line up along the red wall on the west, please. Begin with Mr. Cyrus' class. These students are earning their certificates today. David Baker, Rick Britton. I'm going to ask you to wait to applaud for all of them until they get all over here, because we have so many of them. Jennifer Delaire, Megan Garnaccia, Kaylee Hammond, Marisa Hilty, Nicole Jury, James Keck, Brad Kern, Janae Lehman, Casey Mahoney, Tessa Mulder, Daniel Nixon, Kelly Nyberg, Eric O'Sullivan, Stephen Peslaski, John Panchera, Joe Redoubty. Amanda Scott. Crystal Stamper. Natalie Venuto. Chelsea Walker. Bart Wittett. Natalie Williams. Ken Winsand. Let's give a big round of applause. Mrs. Swift students, while they're being seated, you may line up along the wall. Okay, Mrs. Swift students, Brittany Aiken, Jamie Atkinson, Danielle Bloomfield, Michael Chrisman, Lauren Cohan, Alexis Daimling, Melanie Everett, Brian Jinks, Katie Lawson, Aaron Medrano, Charles Melnick, Julie Miller, Michael Lacuna, Jacob Oberg, Chuck Patterson, Aaron Powers, Stephanie Schmidt, Katie Scott, William Steinfield, Scott Sutton, Nathan Turner, and Oompi Wee. Congratulations to these students. You You may be seated in Ms. Fortino's. You may take the place at the wall. Okay, from Ms. Fortino's class this year, we have Dallas Bird. Jimmy Carr. Zach Crawford. Brittany Crisp. Serena DeBoer, Gabrielle Fainer, Alyssa Fleeser, Tori Gentile, Katie Gunn, Sarah Hall, Justin Holton, Amanda James, Justin McAdams, Alisa Miller, Rebecca Mullen, Alana Nelson, Nathan Newport, Angie Nichols, Alicia Paul, Anthony Rahar, Brittany Rugg, Kevin Shea, Amanda Smith, Aaron White, congratulations to Ms. Fortino's students. You may be seated, and next we have students from the MAC. Okay, in Mr. Buchholz and Mrs. King's class this year, we are honoring the following people: Ted Baker, Crystal Caven. Samantha Chafin. Emily Detweiler. Mark Donovan. David Dutter. Aram Khan. Jeff Yancity. Taylor Kessner. Thomas McCormick.
Thomas.
Ashley McCombs. Jacob Mitchell. Tim Ranbarger. Melissa Scripter. Justin Seacon. Sandra Sessions. Charity Smith. Danielle Smith. Mary Sumbo. Mike Thalen. Heather Thomas. Vince Van Bleck. George White. Thank you, and you may be seated, and Mrs. Jackson's class may take the west wall. Mrs. Jackson's students. We start with Corey Aikman. Laura Beckert. Lauren Bowman. Heavenly Bentz. Lucas Bowman. Sage Brown. Michael Carr. Jenny Currier. Jeff DeVore. Alisa Eastwood. Max Griffith. Brian Hebden. Kinsey Tyler. Dylan Emery. Andy Martin. Elizabeth Minima. Seth Moore. Tiffany Morrow. Anna O'Connor. Jeff Pulaski. Janelle Prether. Sarah Radke. Amanda Rappeljay. Kevin Roman. And Shayna Sutberry. Congratulations to Mrs. Jackson's student. Before we dismiss you for refreshments, I also just wanted to mention your students will be coming home today also with a caricature that has been done by an artist we've had work for us this year. She's worked for us several years, and early in the school year, we collect information from the students about their favorite hobbies, and we send this information off to our caricaturist, and she does wonderful caricatures for the kids, so those will be coming home. We tried to display them for you on the wall in the hall. We put them all up yesterday, 125 of them, and when we came in this morning, about 120 of them were laying on the floor because nothing sticks to the walls with all of the humidity we had. So those will be given to your students. Either they've already received them or they'll be receiving them in just a little bit later in their classroom. We do want to thank everybody for coming, parents, for all the support you give your children all through the year, our Meridian Township police officers for all they do for us here at school, and kids, of course, for all that you give to us all through the year. You really make school a great place to be. So we want to thank everybody, and we will have refreshments. And at the time we had to set up our refreshments, it looked like it might rain at any moment. So they are in the multipurpose room, even though your program says the courtyard. If you'd like to go outside to the courtyard with your refreshments, it might be a little cooler, but you don't need to. You're welcome to stay in the multipurpose room and enjoy some social time together in the multipurpose room, or you may go on out to the courtyard. Thank you for being here.